Gianna Volpe Report, brought to you in part by Village Overhead Door in Southold, by the Duncan Inn in Jamesport, and by the Peconic Cellar Door.
Did I mention
that the microphone is live?
Are we on?
Yes.
Oh, hi.
That's why I yelled
Hello.
At you. That's why I yelled at you that
we're back on. So if anyone heard, I want to own a home out here and raise a family.
I said good luck with that.
Yeah. I'm here with Kim Covell, special sections editor at the Press Newsgroup, also the captain of the Flying Point Foundation for Autism's team for Bike to the Beach, which is, you know, an autism fundraiser. Mm-hmm. In its 10th year now. Flying Point Foundation, or?
Yes, and we're actually talking about two things.
Okay.
Flying Point Foundation for Autism is a nonprofit that I started, inspired by the fact that I do have a 19-year-old who's significantly impacted by autism. And there is an organization that runs bike rides, or rides bike rides, I don't know how you would say that, all over the United States.
Which is so cool.
Called Bike to the Beach.
Yeah, they're all over there in Chicago.
About 5 years ago, they contacted me because they needed to get their permit in Southampton Town.
Ah.
And as you know, to do an event in Southampton Town, you have to be affiliated with a local nonprofit. So they chose us, so I helped them out, and I was able to arrange the permit, but I wasn't involved. And then
until 2016.
2016 right. was my first year, and I had already turned 50 years old, but I did a story for the paper called Fit at 50.
And, very cool.
Yes, and my friend Jeffrey Thayer from JT Personal Fitness took on the challenge of whipping me back into shape. And I wasn't in horrible shape, but I was 50, 50 plus. And I'm very goal-oriented, so one of the goals that I set was to actually participate in Bike to the Beach. So I recruited a couple of friends.
106 miles, a mere bag of shells.
Right, 106 miles, and it runs from Lower Manhattan, and at the time it went to John Scott's in West Hampton
Beach. Is it not going to John Scott's this year?
Goes to Dockers this year and last year, which is phenomenal. We love John Scott's. But Dockers has got a much better parking lot, so it made it better for our friends and family to actually park there and greet us and have a drink.
Still Dune Road.
Road 106 miles.
Yeah.
So I had such a phenomenal time the first year that I did it. And so what happens is when you sign on with Bike to the Beach, a person like me who has their own nonprofit, we sign on as a partner. And so the money that my team raises comes back to the Flying Point Foundation, comes back here to the East End, and we get a check from
them. So smart.
And it so people know that when they're giving to me or giving to any of my teammates, the money is coming right back here. And it's supporting the programs of Flying Point, which I don't know if you know about them.
Which, by the way, congratulations on smashing your $15,000 goal, and now you're on your way to 18.
We're on our way to 18. I'm hoping to break 20, but it would be really... I like round numbers.
Yes, same. I was actually wondering about that. I was thinking, I'm like, why? I wonder why they chose 18 instead of 20. And then I was like, well, maybe that
gets
it.
Let you in on every secret.
Right. I've been thinking about it in my noodle about why.
It's gonna,
and it makes sense.
20 is the real goal, because it feels really good to go beyond your goal.
Yes.
And I have a personal goal of $7,000. I'm a little short of it now. So if anybody wants to get out there and go to biketothebeach.org and look for Kim Covell, they can certainly make a donation there.
And the Flying Point Foundation's website is fpf4autism.org. And that's a numeral 4.
Right. And you can find out what we do there, which, if you have a second, I can tell you a little bit about what we do.
Yes, please do.
We started 10 years ago, as you mentioned, and when I started, my son was a little boy. He was 8 or 9 years old, and at that time, there was a real dearth of recreational programs for kids with autism, especially those that had an inclusive model, which means that kids who do not have autism are also invited to come. So it took us 2 years to raise enough money to start our summer camp. So in 2010, we opened our first 8-day summer camp. Actually, it was 5 days at that time. And it was a huge success, and we've been growing ever since.
Phenomenal.
Yes, and we offer rec programs throughout the year. Where, in fact, we have one on Saturday that's going to be at the Long Island Petting Zoo. We go to the aquarium. We go to the trampoline place, and we bring the staff, and we pay the admission for the families, but the families can drop their children off and go and enjoy these activities with the support that they need.
Phenomenal.
Also very important, because school's not out yet, we do teacher grants for teachers who need some sort of an unusual item that's not covered by a school budget, and they would like it in their classroom to enhance
very
the learning
cool,
experience.
Yes.
We give scholarships to students with autism, and we give scholarships to high school seniors who do not have autism, who have demonstrated a commitment to the autism community. And we actually have three winners this year, believe it or not. Well, actually, we have three non-autism student winners and one student with autism. We gave out $4,000 worth of scholarships this year, which is phenomenal. And finally, and really, really important, is when I started this 10 years ago, we had all these adorable children in our summer camp, and all of those kids now, 10 years later, are teenagers, which really underlined for us the need for services for adults with autism. So our goal now, in addition to everything else we do, is to create a lifelong learning and activity center for individuals with autism in adulthood. And for years we've been looking for a place, because as you well know, since you're probably looking at house prices, real estate around here is a little expensive.
Yeah.
So we're hoping to get some cooperation either from government or from a generous benefactor, that we can get a piece of property, and we've been saving our money so that we can build an activity center that would serve this very, very pressing need that's not ever, ever going to go away.
Right, and actually is growing. And, you know, I believe that it'll happen. I see it.
I'm goal-oriented, remember?
Yes, it'll happen.
And that's our goal.
Unbelievable story. Very cool. So we're a week out.
Yes, we're actually next Thursday we'll be loading up our bikes. And I also want to mention, I said JT Personal Fitness, who did my training, he's a sponsor. And then, he's riding.
Right,
he's
riding
with
now.
Us.
I saw that.
We also have Rotations is offering some special services. He gave some special deals for people who needed bikes for the team. They're tuning up our bikes. And Hometown Taxi is getting us in there.
I saw that.
They're taking in 8 of the riders who need a ride and 8 of our bikes.
That's amazing.
Which has some logistics involved, but we're figuring it out. We're not going in a yellow taxi. We're going in a van. So.
Very, very nice. So talk about the training for this type of an event.
Well, it's been a little challenge with the weather this year. I mean, last year I was out, you know, late February, early March, riding, but I also have a life. So to squeeze it into everything else that I do that's another challenge. But we just ride. I organize training rides for the team.
And there was also some like 20 something rides. You had some other rides that you guys have done?
Well, I just set up a training ride.
Okay.
They can meet me and we can go out for a certain distance and just try to keep pushing it. And this week, just past weekend, a teammate and I, we joined another group of riders and we did 32 miles. That's probably going to be it. I mean, because it's supposed to be raining this weekend, but maybe a couple team members have high hopes of riding out to Montauk this weekend from Southampton.
Wow.
We'll see how that goes. We'll see how that goes.
The,
but you know what?
The
bike to the beach is not a race.
Right.
So really anybody can do it. I mean, it is a challenge and you are tired and it does take a lot of mental toughness to, when you want to stop, to just keep going. But it's not a race. So you just go at your own pace. There's plenty of stops, plenty of support, plenty of food.
About every 10 to 15 miles.
About that.
Stop.
The first leg is the longest and probably the most challenging because it goes through Brooklyn, lots of turns, lots of bridges that I do not like.
Oh, you don't like
I get
over
off and
bridges?
Walk. There's one bridge you have to walk over, but there's another bridge
do you guys go over the Manhattan Bridge?
We go over Brooklyn Bridge at sunrise.
Wow.
It's almost worth doing just for that. And last year I did actually stop on the top of the Brooklyn Bridge and took a photo.
Oh, good.
And you can see that on my Facebook page, which is really cool.
So Peter Booty's doing it. Is this the first time?
This is the first year I recruited Peter. Peter was my boss a long time ago at the Southampton Press, and he had always been a cyclist then, and I always admired the fact that he rode from North Haven to the press office, and I've been kind of bugging him for a couple of years, and this year he finally said yes.
That's awesome.
Yeah, and when are we going to get you?
Oh my gosh, I would love that.
Next year, 2019.
Well, I'd have to train for it.
Well, that's,
but I can. But you can help.
You can help. You can ride indoors in the winter. You
I'm
can,
very
you can just spin. There you go. Next year.
Next year, yeah. Bike to the beach.
Bike
imagine
to the beach.
Imagine that.
Gianna on the team.
We'll see. Just another shout out for the website, fpf4autism.org. I'm very excited about this community center. I'm dreaming of it with you.
That's great. So keep spreading the word, because this is the hard part.
So how do we get more donations there? They go to the Bike to the Beach?
If they want to support the team, they can go to biketothebeach.org, and they can search for me, Kim Covell. They can search for the team. Maybe there's another team member they'd like to support. It all goes to the same place.
Right.
So I'm the furthest from my goal, only because I make the loftiest goal, and that is expected, I would say, of a captain. So there
right.
you go. You know, I'm driving this ship. I got to raise a lot of money. That would be the best place to do it, just so that it supports this endeavor.
biketothebeach.org.
Yep.
What about you, Bruce? You coming with us?
He leaves 2019. I'm working on recruiting Brian from Hometown Taxi, because he actually has an affiliation with autism as well.
Does he?
And yes, and that's for him to talk about, but he supported this cause very willingly, and he did say he used to cycle in the past, so we'll see.
So is there any, how can people get involved in the organization otherwise? To go to the website?
They can go to the website. There's a contact us page.
Is there anything that you guys are looking for?
It's really great to go to our Facebook page too.
Okay.
Because there'll be the links to it, and you just need to look for Flying Point Foundation for Autism. There's links to all of the information about Bike to the Beach. There's information about our activities. That's where you get the most up-to-date news. I think we all kind of forget about websites now. We all seem to go right to social media. I don't know why that is.
Right.
Yeah. So, I'll go back to my website. Like, ooh, I should have taken that
down. I think it has to do with the addictive element of social media, because they say it activates the same parts of your brain as like a casino and like winning. So,
well, I mean, just in terms of getting information out there, it's more real time than going to a website.
Right.
So
well,
I think
because it's in the midst of people doing the whole checking thing.
But you can find out a lot about us there. So I hope people will come and check it out, because we do a lot of really great work. We've got a lot of great families that we help, and we're ever growing. We get more people added to our list pretty much weekly, because we've got a great young woman who handles our rec programs, and so she's really great about recruiting people.
Well, Miss Covell, best of luck next week. We got to wrap this up, but please do donate. Go to biketothebeach.org or fpf4autism.org. Check out the Flying Point Foundation for Autism website or their Facebook, which is where you probably will go.
Yep, there'll be a lot of information there, and I hope that next week, if you're on at this time, that you'll be checking in and saying, I wonder how they're doing.
Absolutely.
Around 9 o'clock, we'll be on,
absolutely
we'll be
will.
On Long Island.
And we had Nancy Kouris give you guys a shout-out last segment as well.
Love Nancy. She
Everyone
made those
does.
Cookies for us. They're on. You could see them on our Facebook page.
So we gotta run.
Thanks, Gianna.
Check back again next week on the Gianna Volpe Report here on 1390 WRIV, your hometown station.
An overhead door serves a purpose, and it should be as beautiful as the rest of your home or building. For more than 30 years, Village Overhead Doors has been creating and installing beautiful garage doors for contractors and homeowners on the North and South Forks. They also install automatic garage door openers that open with the click of a remote, so there's no getting out of the car in bad weather. For a wide range of styles, from lifetime steel doors to custom-made wood doors, and for all your garage door needs, please call 765-4963 today and find out how your garage door can be a beautiful focal point of your home or building's exterior. Village Overhead Doors of Southold. 765-4963.
Make the call and let them add beauty and value to your home or business.
The Peconic Cellar Door, 2885 Peconic Lane in Peconic, is open. Come see the North Fork's newest tasting room and enjoy Bukkanonology wines, As If wines, and Saltbird Cellar wines, all in an intimate, comfortable farmhouse setting that sets the North Fork apart. Robin Epperson McCarthy and Ali Shaper are looking forward to meeting you. Monday night is Locals Night, with discounts between 4 and 7. While you're there, bring home a bottle of Saltbird Cellar wine, Bukkanonology wine, or As If wine. Excellent with dinner or to sip while you're sitting outside in the early evening hours. And bring a skeleton key and have some fun telling and hearing stories at the Peconic Cellar Door. The Peconic Cellar Door, 2885 Peconic Lane in Peconic.